Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Today, we are here to learn about the team structure of eCell that we have in our Sangam entrepreneurs. We have various positions being held by many of our colleagues, and I am here to highlight their key responsibilities and just introduce to you the present representatives of eCell. And lay out some rules and regulations that we will be using up to select the next set of leaders and designates who will be representing the eCell in future years. Fine. This is what we will see. We will see who are all the faculty advisors that we have to help us through. And then we will go through the portfolio of present eCell team members. And while we go through the key responsibilities of each designation and the elected or selected member who are in present eCell team. And finally, we'll be there to see the guidelines through which we'll select or elect the future team of our eCell. These are the faculty advisors, our respectable principal ma'am, Dr. D. Jayanti, our HOD, Dr. M. P. Chitra, Mr. Ganesh Subramaniam, our associate professor, and Dr. M. Prem Kumar sir, who has been very supportive beginning from the start of this NEC event. So I would like to note that here. And let's go for the portfolio of our present NEC team members. First, we'll call this position or designation as overall coordinator or the team member, I mean team lead. The key responsibilities of a team lead would be to control the events from conception to cleanup. That is, from starting to the end, he'll have to control the whole event. So that would be the prime responsibility of a team lead. And then dissemination of duties, quite obvious. Like, he'll have to distribute the work that that's available to the various designations which are under his control, like which we'll see further. And then organization and negotiation. And negotiation comes up when we have to talk to an NGO or we have to represent an NEC at the administration or something like that. That is when negotiation comes in. And then most important thing is creation of a positive environment where we can get the work done from our colleagues with whom we work. And the present overall coordinators or team lead, I would like to introduce myself. I am Vivek Anand, final year EC department. And we have Sharmila Bhaskaran, who is another team lead from the final year EC department. Thank you, Sharmila. Next, we have one more important team to start with, potential harness team. The key responsibility of this team is to tap the potential from the students who have the potential with them and have failed to come up and expose it to the world. And to tap those potentials and create platform for them is the key responsibility of this designation. For this, presently we have Mr. Kadha Sharif, my colleague, and Mr. J. Ranjit Kumar there. And they hold this position and they have been satisfying this role very successfully right from the beginning. I would take pleasure in introducing them to you all. Thank you, Kadha. And the next team is Science for the Society team. This is one more important team that has to be integral part throughout the future years too. I feel that personally, because you can see the key responsibilities is to search the needs of the layman and document the possible solutions for that. We are researching into the needs of a layman, and we are trying to find engineering solutions to that through our engineering wing in this college. So that is the main purpose and responsibility of this designation. At our present eCell team, we have Mr. Arvind C. as lead for this designation, and Mr. Rajkumar R. to support him from third year mechanical department. And he is also being very supportive right from the beginning and has been punctual in completing whatever task has been assigned to him. Thank you, Arvind. And next is Corporate Connect. Corporate Connect is very important, so whenever we have to do something with entrepreneurship, something connecting with corporate is in the part. So key responsibilities, you can go through this slide. And present members of eCell who represent this designation are Mr. Naveen P, who is unfortunately not present here. Okay, and then we have Mr. Vinod A, third year, who is again not present. Okay, fine. Then I see public connect. But public connect is as important as corporate connect. And for that we have Ms. Riya and Priyadarshini in this designation. I thank them for their support from the beginning. And the next important designations that Ms. Sangeeta R and Jason Daniel hold are small scale industry development team. The main key responsibility of this team is to identify the budding entrepreneurs in the in the environment that's around our college or in the vicinity near our house something, and help them to create a platform for them to flourish and nourish. That's it. Next, marketing team. The roles are quite obvious, and we have Ms. Sandhya Bhargavi and Mr. Pradeep Kumar at present in this designation. Thank you so much. Next, the event organizers, they form an integral part of ESIP, organizing every event. So these three are the designation holders. Wealth management, Mr. Lokesh Kumar and Sarvanand, they have been very supportive, and without them, blogs and Facebook pages and YouTube channels would not have been possible. Operational team, whenever an event has to be organized, this background support is very important. We have Mr. Albert Tanasingh, who has been organizing this team. And with him support, we have Amman Paris, who is not present here. Okay, fine. This is all about the present team structure of ESIP. And we have formulated a few rules and regulations to select our next future teams. And you can go through that. Next slide. The first will be for our team lead, and he will be elected unanimously. And next slide. And this is for the other designates. They will be selected based on the present ESIL team's decision and the faculty advisor's decision. Thank you.